Hi, it's Mike Chen. Ever since H.G. Wells published his book, Time Machine, in 1885, people have been interested in the topic of time travel. Many have attempted to explain it, some have tried to do it, but most attempts led to failures. But recently, a university professor and avid reader of everything related to black holes and science fiction has supposedly proven that time travel is indeed possible, well, at least mathematically. According to a new study revealed by Ben Tippett, a math and physics instructor at the University of British Columbia, people think of time travel as something of fiction, and we tend to think it's not possible because we don't actually do it, but mathematically it is possible. Tippett's study was released in the IPL Science Journal Classical and Quantum Gravity, and the description of his study states, "In this paper, we present geometry which has been designed to fit a layperson's description of a time machine. It is a box which allows those within it to travel backwards and forwards through time and space, as interpreted by an external observer. Time-like observers travel within the interior of a bubble of geometry, which moves along a circular, acasual trajectory through space-time. If certain time-like observers inside the bubble maintain a persistent acceleration, their world lines will close." Tippett said in his study that we shouldn't really be looking at a three-dimensional space, but instead a four-dimensional one where different directions are connected. Basing his research off Einstein's theory, he explains that space-time is curved, which results in planets in the universe having curved orbits. So to picture this in your head, think of yourself standing next to a huge star. And at the place you're standing, the geometry in space-time is curved, which means everything near the star and you included is going to have a curved trajectory and create a curved path around the star. So from another point of view, in a flat and uncurved space-time, planets and stars would move in straight lines rather than curved lines. In Tippett's words, the time direction of the space-time surface also shows curvature. There is evidence showing the closer to a black hole we get, time moves slower. My model of a time machine uses the curved space-time to bend time into a circle for the passengers, not in a straight line. That circle takes us back in time. In this study, Tippett showcased his mathematical model called the Traversable Acasual Retrograde Domain in Space-Time, or TARDIS. His model basically showcases a bubble of space-time geometry that moves 8 times faster than the speed of light, allowing it to move backwards in time. In other words, he wants to use the curvature of space-time in the universe to bend time into a circle for passengers sitting in the time machine, and that circle allows them to travel into the future and past. He says it is a box which travels forwards and then backwards in time along a circular path through space-time. Delighted external observers would be able to watch the time travelers within the box evolving backwards in time, unbreaking eggs and separating cream from their coffee. And if you look at this picture, you'll get a better idea of what I'm talking about. You see here, person A is the time machine passenger, and person B is the observer. Both person A and person B will experience time in dramatically different ways. Within the bubble, A will see the B's events periodically evolve and then reverse. Outside the bubble, observer B will see two versions of A emerge from the same location. One's clock hands will turn clockwise, the other counterclockwise. Of course, if something sounds too good to be true, it's probably not. Although Tippett has done a great amount of research and possibly proven the existence of time travel, doubts that anyone will actually be able to build a workable time machine anytime soon. He says H.G. Wells popularized the term time machine, and he left people with the thought that an explorer would need a machine or special box to actually accomplish time travel. While it is mathematically feasible, it is not yet possible to build a space time machine because we need materials, which we call exotic matter, to bend space time in these impossible ways, but they have yet to be discovered. To put it simply, Tippett came up with a model of a possible time traveling machine, but we don't have the necessary materials to build the machine with our current technological advances. Not until, you know, somebody falls, hits their head, and comes up with the flux capacitor. Or you know what might be easier? Find a time traveler that's already here from the future and just take his ship. Also, I feel like certain forms of time travel don't really need equipment. But seriously, this is pretty cool that now mainstream science is looking more and more into these sci-fi, Star Trek-y technologies. But I do feel like a time machine is one of those inventions that really should never be invented, although it probably is already invented in the future and people probably have already used it to come back here, just because there's so many crazy things that could go wrong when there's a time machine sitting there. I mean, we as human beings, we're gonna be tempted to change history to either prevent a war or prevent our own genocide, or if it falls in the hands of someone crazy to maybe conquer the world. And I think somebody already used it to go back in time and change the Forrest Gump script from life is like a box of chocolates to life was like a box of chocolates. But seriously, I don't know. I feel like a time machine could only cause more trouble. So let me now turn the question to you guys. What do you think of all this? Let's say we have the ability to build a time machine. Should we even do it? Do you think that's good for mankind? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you all so much for watching this video. I'll see you later.